the Diary of a Wimpy Kid tier list. Here I've organized all the books in order. Or actually, they were in order until I put it in presentation mode. Now they're not. So yeah, today we're going to be putting all of the Diary of a Wimpy Kid books, including the Rowley Jefferson books, and some of the other miscellaneous books, into a tier list, S being the best, the absolute best of the best, the greatest, and D being just straight up garbage. Let's get into it. So, we're gonna go like from the first book to the last book. The first book, Diary of a Wimpy Kid, it was a good start. Now, the only thing is, this book is a bit weird because it's like a whole year, and usually that doesn't happen in Diary of a Wimpy Kid books. Usually it's just like a season or something. So this is an interesting thing that happened in the first book that didn't actually carry on to the other books. It's a good start, but it's not like amazing. So I'd really say the S tier is like best of the best. A is amazing. B is good. This is a good Diary of a Wimpy Kid book, I'd say. Now next up we have Roderick Rules. Now this book was a great book that made for an even better movie. I'm gonna have to put it in S. The movie made me like this book a lot more. And yeah, I don't know. I didn't really consider it something special until like last year. I really started getting into the movies a lot and I just kept watching Roderick Rules. It's my all-time favorite. Dog Days is good, but essentially Roderick Rules is just a great book. But is it my favorite? I'm not actually sure. You'll have to stay tuned until the end when I actually put them all, like, arrange them all and rank them accordingly. Next up, we have The Last Straw. Now, this is... I don't know. A lot of people say, like, oh, the first six books, they're all S tier. No, they really aren't. Last Straw is C, and I'm gonna be honest, take all everything I see here with a grain of salt, because I did not reread all the books for this. I only recently read Big Shot, or like the first week it came out. But yeah, so these books are not at all fresh in my head. But The Last Straw, I think what's good about it is it's Dog Days, like the Dog Days movie actually combined aspects of The Last Straw and Dog Days, and it made for like a really good movie. And that brings us to the next book, Dog Days. I'm gonna put Dog Days in A tier. I think that if, like, it was actually kind of based off the movies, which is weird because the movies are based off the books, of course, if it was kind of a combination of 3 and 4, it would be an S tier. If there was, like, if it was mainly Dog Days with some aspects of The Last Straw like we saw in the movie, I would have really liked that and that would be an S tier. But so far, we have, like, all the books. And what's really nice about this is next one is number 5, and I'm actually gonna put this in a D tier, so it kind of has a cool rainbow. But yeah, why is this in D tier? Well, okay, first of all, I didn't really discuss The Last Straw and Dog Days. Now, Last Straw, it's kind of forgettable. I don't really remember what happened. It's not too special. Roderick Rules really kind of goes off to his relationship with his brother, and then the first one's with Rowley, of course, his like friendship with him. Now, the third one's with his father, and I feel like that really could have been incorporated into Dog Days. And I don't know, I feel like that would have been just a way better thing. Just, like, he worried about SPAG Union as an actual, like, military school and not, like, a summer camp or something. Yeah, I don't know, I wish that was kind of like, his dad being disappointed in him was an aspect of Dog Days instead of The Last Straw. Because that's kind of all the book was built around, and it was kind of a weak plot. The Ugly Truth is actually the first ever Diary of a Wimpy Kid book I've read, so it's really nostalgic for me. However, that does not stop it from being in the D tier. I just didn't find this one that interesting on rereading. It has its moments, and there's no such thing as a bad Wimpy Kid book, in my opinion. I can't say the same about movies. We're not going to be talking about the long haul here. But, yeah. Anyway, so yeah, The Ugly Truth, it's just really, I don't know. I'd say it's the first bad Wimpy. Yeah, actually, no, that's not true. It's definitely the lowest of the original. Now, the last, I'd say, original one is Cabin Fever. And when I say original, I mean, like, the original six is what most people refer to. Now, I'm going to put this in A tier. It's a good book. I really like it, and I think this would have made for a great movie. And unfortunately, the animated one we're getting is based off of the first book, which is a bit of a disappointment. I really wish it would be based off Cabin Fever, especially since it's coming out around Christmas time. It would be a great theme for a new theme for the movies to explore. I'm really looking forward to seeing the movie, though. And maybe I'll do a separate video when that movie comes out on ranking all the movies, even though a lot of them don't really compare to the others. Next up after this, I believe we have The Third Wheel. Now, this is a book that I think is decent. I'm between B and C here. But ultimately, I do want to space things out a bit, so I'm gonna have to put it in B tier. Actually, no, I'm putting it in B tier. It's a good book. I think it really builds up to a really evident, a really like, it builds up to a climax. It has like a definite climax, which is not a thing that a lot of these books have, but some of them do. I would say the first one doesn't really. Yeah, I guess Rowley eating the cheese in this one, Roderick rules the talent show. Dog Days, I don't know. It has like, I don't know. It doesn't really have one. Cabin Fever doesn't really have one. Last Straw, I'm not sure. I don't really remember. It's not forgetful. Ugly Truth doesn't really have one. So this one actually has a climax, which really puts it in B. If it didn't, if it just kind of took the eh route with like the not really having a climax route like the other books, then it would be lower. But yeah. What else do we have? Hard Luck. This used to be my favorite book for some reason. But I now think it's A tier. This is an unpopular opinion right here. I really like the aspect of Greg's Magic 8-Ball. I like the aspect of the menace to society kids and the forest. That one line I really remember is Meckly Mingo's gonna get you. And I don't know, I was just like, well, now that is a menace to society. There's also some really fun moments, like when Greg's just trying to like juke stuff out with his new shoes and he tries to come up with the ideas. I don't know, it's a really fun book. And I think that the only problem with it is I don't know, it doesn't really, I don't think it has a definite climax as far as I remember. He also has, it has a lot of plots going on. Also does goes on the cliche that like Rowley and Greg aren't friends anymore, which has already happened twice, so this is the third time that's happening. Not a big fan of that, to be honest, but I don't know, it's interesting. But overall, it's low A tier. It's like an A minus, I'd say. I don't want to put it in B tier because personally I really enjoy it, and I think younger me would have put this in S tier for sure. But yeah. So next up we have The Long Haul. Controversial because of the movie, and it's unfortunate because honestly, it's a really good book. I'm gonna have to put it, I don't want to put it in S tier because the movie really damaged its reputation. But I don't know. I feel like I have to put it in S tier because there's not gonna be. I wanna. No. I'm putting it in S tier. It's a really good book. It's a really good book. It's one of the best. It's a really fun story. And road trip movies just aren't the same as. It's really easy to make a road trip movie. They're really cheap to make. But a road trip book is pretty cool, especially this one. This one's really good. And I actually don't. I have no idea what I'm talking about right now. I'm just. I don't know. I'm just rambling. But yeah, it's a really good book. Road trip movies just suck, and that's why the movie sucked. And yeah, so this one, it has a really good plot, and it just we got you have those. I really like this kind of side story of them of Greg trying to avoid the like the. That one family, the Beardos, he calls them. That's really fun. And when they rob them, and Greg's dad has to run out naked, that's interesting. But yeah, so that's pretty much yeah. Another really good Diary of a Wimpy Kid book is Old School. I really love this one. It's an S tier for me. This is the first one I believe that I actually bought on release at the book fair. I remember it quite clearly. I was at my school book fair in grade 3, and one of the kids' name was Julian, and I'm like, oh, that's my name too. I love this book. But I reread it and I really enjoy it. I really like the Hasgerbal Farms and how he doesn't plan to go there, but he's like, it's my only choice. I have nowhere to run. And there's just a lot of cool tie-ins, and I think that story of Silas Scratch and how Greg's dad made him up. It's just, I don't know, I just really like this book. It has a really cool, like, it has a lot of cool, like, it has a really cool first act with, like, the no power thing. Some cool side characters in Fru, and his cabin mates are pretty cool and funny. And this book just works, and it's on so many levels. And I think it's really cool to see two back-to-back really good books. Now, Double Down. Now, this is another average Wimpy Kid book, I'd say. It's on the same level as the first one, and it really reminds me of it, probably just because of the cover. But no, it just has a lot of the ideas from the first one. And I don't know, like the becoming famous thing is a plot that I feel like Greg's tried to do before, but maybe that's just, like, Roderick Rules, the movie, talking. But I don't know. I just think it was a pretty average book. There's just not really much to say about it, to be honest. The climax with Rowley getting stuck in a tree, it's interesting. There's a lot of this book I like, a lot I don't like. Greg joining band is interesting. I really like that plot line, actually, when Greg joins band. It's one of my favorite. Me myself, actually, used to be in band. Anyway, it's an interesting book. Pretty solid. Next up, we have The Getaway. Now, I think this is another book that has a lot... It's a book that has a lot of, like, laugh-out-loud moments, but the book itself isn't too good. The story is kind of... I think a lot of people don't like this movie. I mean, this book. Just because, if you compare it to The Long Haul, it's not close. I'm putting it in B tier. Because I think that it has a really good story. The airport, the hecticness, Greg going on a plane for the first time is a fun experience to see. And just him going on vacation, being scared of stuff, and kind of getting adapted to this new environment. Because it's a really interesting concept, because we always see Greg in, like, old America. But we never see him. And it's really interesting to see him in a different country, is the point. But yeah, I think it's a good book. I'm kind of debating on putting it in A tier the more I think about it. I think it's just going to go to the front of the B tier, and I haven't really arranged the tiers yet, but just going to get a head start on that. Next up, we have Diary of a Wimpy Kid, The Meltdown. I really like this book as it has the return of the Mingos from Hard Luck. I'm putting it in A tier. Essentially, this is just an all-out war. It kind of world-builds his neighborhood, which is nice. It has a pretty cool story, a lot of funny moments, and a climax, which is just... It's pretty much Avengers Endgame, except Diary of a Wimpy Kid. The Mingos show up, everybody's just fighting. Greg and Rowley are hiding for their lives. Greg makes a snow fort. It's a really interesting concept that it's just great. I really want to reread this one. I really remember enjoying it a lot of times while reading it. And yeah, next up we have Wrecking Ball. This one, it's pretty good. But the more I look at it, the more I think Third Wheel should be in C tier, because I've been thinking about it, and Third Wheel, it's good, but I don't know, it's not great. It has the first two, like, thirds of the book are kind of the first and second act. The third act picks it up a lot, but second act sets up a lot up, it's just pretty much just setting up the third act. But other than that, back to Wrecking Ball. It's a really cool story, but it doesn't go anywhere. And I feel like it could have been a great finale to the series. Not that I want it to end, but it kind of hinted at it. Not that it's happening, because Jeff Kinney has gone on record saying that the series will end when he ends, when he dies, in case you guys didn't pick that up. But yeah, so Wrecking Ball, it's a good book. I really like kind of the hecticness of them trying to move, them trying to renovate the house. It going right and then everything just going wrong. That's really interesting, but other than that, it's a pretty average book. Now, the second to last one is The Deep End. This one has a lot of good moments. I'm going to put it in C tier, though, because it's already been done twice, and this isn't a really unique way of doing it. It's pretty much like The Long Haul, and The Getaway's like The Long Haul, so it's pretty much a third iteration of this, and every time it gets a bit worse. Not to say The Getaway's bad. Again, I really want to put it in A tier, but I don't want to put all the books. These are all really good books. There's no bad books. I enjoy all of these. I could reread any of these any day. The Deep End, though, it has a lot of funny moments, but as an overarching story, it's not the best. Now, essentially, it's just this one, road trip. This one, plane trip, like vacation. This one is camping trip, kind of. Road trip, then camping trip. Has a lot of good moments. Like I said, it's pretty much just like a lot of laugh-out-loud moments. It's not, like, a great overarching story, which is something, like, those two, Diary of a Wimpy Kid is two things, just, like, the moments that make you laugh, and the good story, and the S tier and A tier books combine both of those, and maybe the A tier books are lacking in some of those, but other than that, they're pretty good. Now, B tier usually does one of these really well. I don't know where I'm going with this, to be honest, but yeah, Deep End, it's C tier, deal with it. Oh my god, Diary of a Wimpy Kid Big Shot. This is the newest one. I don't know. Now, this might be an unpopular opinion. I read this book, and I don't know. It might just be me, but I absolutely loved it. It is one of my favorite, if not my favorite book. It's going maybe it's not better. It's okay, hold on. Hold on. Okay, now that we're done pretty much all the Wimpy Kid books, let's rearrange them accordingly. Actually, let's talk about Big Shot first. Now, I really love how it's, like, focused on sports. I like how it's focused on basketball of all sports because it's an interesting sport. It has a really cool climax, and Greg's being kind of he's showing sociopathic behavior again with him wanting movie rights, and I don't know, maybe that's more egotistical behavior. But the point is, he's being Greg, and I don't know, I don't want to spoil it too much because it is pretty good, and it's pretty new. So a lot of you guys might have not read it, but I really recommend this one. It's one of the best, like, modern Diary of Wimpy Kid books, for sure. And by modern, when I say modern, I really mean kind of, I think, old school and up. I think they've all been pretty solid. There's been a few outliers, but yeah. So, overall, I'd rank Roger Rules as the best, Old School as the second best, Big Shot as the third best, Long Haul fourth. I think I'll rearrange it like this. Yeah, like this. Dog Days 5th, Meltdown 6th, Cabin Fever 7th, Hard Luck 8th, oh, it's the 8th book, well, what do you know, that's 8th, and then, for this one, for the B tier, what's 9th place? I'd say the original is 9th, Getaway's 10th, Double Down's 11th, I don't know, it could go either way, Wrecking Ball and Double Down are about the same, and then I'd say The Last Straw is 12th, or whatever's next. And then, oh my god. No, Third Wheel, then The Last Straw, then The Deep End, then The Ugly Truth. Now, the other books. Awesome Friendly Kid is really good. It shows a fresh take on Greg Heffley's perspective. Or no, I guess not Greg. It's a fresh look at the Wimpy Kid books because it's kind of Rowley's perspective. And it kind of shows how much of a bad person Greg is. Like when he leaves Rowley for dead in the woods after he breaks his foot, and how Greg's just, I don't know, it has like a lot of funny moments. It's a really cool book. Unfortunately, the other two don't really go, it's not really the same. And it really is unfortunate because the first one, we could just keep getting stuff like the first one. Like, we get Awesome Friendly Kid 2 and just like, Awesome Friendly Kid Volume 2, Volume 3, stuff like that. It doesn't have to be in chronological order, as they're just short stories. But honestly, next one is Friendly Adventure. It's cool, it's just about how Greg and Rowley write a book and kind of that book. Spooky Stories pretty much just has nothing to do with the Wimpy Kid franchise, except slightly implying that some of the characters are based on the characters in the Wimpy Kid franchise. But other than that, it really doesn't have much to do with the Wimpy Kid franchise. It just like has the Rowley Jefferson slapped onto it. So personally, I would actually have to put it in D tier. It's not a bad book per se, but it's not a Diary of a Wimpy Kid book. Now the Do It Yourself book. These can't really be ranked. I'm just gonna say these are just go up to like, I don't know. Wait, no, I did not mean to do that. There, these could go into the miscellany. Can't really be ranked, bro. So this is my ranking. I hope you guys did enjoy it. Make sure to like and subscribe if you did. And, yeah. I spelt this wrong. There we go.